I could not be prouder to stand here as one of the co-chairs of the Women's Health Caucus to let Pennsylvanians know that we are serious about improving the lives of birthing people and their families. We're here today to discuss access to maternal health. We know that Pennsylvania has too many maternal care deserts, and we ask if those who describe themselves as pro-life care so much about babies, why aren't they doing more to address maternity care deserts? Let's face it, babies need healthy mothers who have the resources to feed, clothe, house, and care for them. I'm a legislator, not a doctor, but I remember the great care that I received when I was pregnant. I had regular prenatal visits with my obstetrician. I attended natural birth classes, toured a delivery room, learned that focus on breathing exercises could help me get through the actual delivery. My daughter was caught by a midwife while my doctor took pictures. It was one of my happiest moments, and it was followed by time to recover, to get help with breastfeeding from my midwife. So clearly, I had really good health insurance and great resources in my neighborhood. So to learn that these days in southeastern Pennsylvania, we have maternity care deserts in both Philadelphia and Delaware counties, which join those reported in 2020 by the March of Dimes. And to know that five rural counties in Pennsylvania are considered maternity care deserts, they're Cameron, Forest, Greene, Juniata, and Sullivan. That report is from 2018, and I'm not sure if more have been added in addition to Philadelphia and Delaware County. And so I ask again, what are those who describe themselves as pro-life, as caring so much about babies, why aren't they doing more to address maternity care deserts? Well, here's another reality. Every year for about 20 years, the state's fiscal code legislation carves out, and I quote, money appropriated for women's service program grants to nonprofit agencies whose primary function is to promote childbirth and provide alternatives to abortion shall be expended to provide services to women until childbirth and for up to 12 months thereafter, including food, shelter, clothing, health care, counseling, adoption services, parenting classes, assistance for post-delivery and other supportive programs and services, and for related outreach programs, unquote. Well, this may sound like maternity care. These nonprofits that receive funds are not providing health care. They are not registered as health care providers. They are not subject to patient privacy laws such as HIPAA. These facilities do not take the place of health care providers. So yesterday, I also had the opportunity to meet with doctors representing ACOG, the American College of Obstetrics and Gynecology. ACOG has over 57,000 members and is proud to maintain the highest standards of clinical practice and continuing education for the nation's women's health physicians. Abortion care is included in medical training, clinical practice, and continuing medical education. They talked about sound health policy is best based on scientific fact and evidence-based medicine. And they emphasize that the best health care is provided free of political interference in the patient-physician relationship. And let's ask ourselves, isn't health care supposed to be private? Is it not what HIPAA is all about? Is there any other health care that is so subject to public debate and differences? I don't think so. So, on the positive side, over the past year, the members of the Women's Health Caucus have accompanied Acting Secretary Sneed and her staff to inform new mothers across the state whose health insurance is provided by Medicaid that they have a new benefit because Pennsylvania, under the governance of Tom Wolf, has opted into a program that ensures that all birthing people have access to physical and behavioral health care for the first 12 months after delivering their baby. Access to health care is essential, especially during those first 12 months. As we move into a post-pandemic world, we must not forget that throughout the pandemic, maternal mortality rates have increased dramatically. So this historic investment in the children and the birthing people of Pennsylvania is one of the most important steps that could be taken to combat this issue across the Commonwealth. The review by Pennsylvania's Maternal Mortality Review Committee has provided valuable data for policymakers. Their report on pregnancy-associated deaths in Pennsylvania from 2013 to 2018 defines pregnancy-associated death of a woman while pregnant or up to 1 year from the end of a pregnancy, regardless of the outcome, duration, or site of the pregnancy, including all accidental or incidental causes of maternal death. As we continue to fight the trend of increased maternal mortality, maternal deserts, and a constitutional amendment that would stipulate that abortion in Pennsylvania is not a right, we know that our work is not done. The Women's Health Caucus members include state senators and representatives, as well as many advocacy groups and healthcare providers from all corners of Pennsylvania. Together, we will continue to fight for life-saving care and the well-being of all parents and their babies throughout the Commonwealth.